teach you wood, which means whirlwind. Wood. You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thorn. Quick mastery of a new thume is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengraf. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. He was a great war leader of the ancient Nord, a master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born. The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance. That is commendable. But remember, the dragon blood is itself a gift of Akatosh. Do not try to deny that gift. Your destiny requires you to use your voice. Why else would Akatosh have bestowed this power upon you? If you remember to use your voice in service to the purpose of Akatosh, you will remain true to the way. Five. Our leader, Partanax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him. As I said, you will know you are ready when your voice can open the path to him. Sky?
Need a ride? Where do you want to go?
Climb and back, and we'll be off. There once was a hero named Ragnar Red who came riding to right run from old Rorik.
The Jarl going to do about it?
The Legion's always looking for strong, capable warriors.
How are we supposed to feel safe?
You think you've got what it takes?
Homes.
Our headquarters is in
sight. Enough already. I have told Ygritte of your concerns. She'll look after you all. Please, go about your business.
We have no need for wizards in our midst.
Morthon has enough problems as it is.
It's no use. Let's get back to it then. Unless it's about the mill, I don't have time to talk. Too much to do. The world's going mad, and our Jarl does what? She hides inside with her visions. We need a leader, not some mystic. How can I? She never speaks with us. She's allowed this wizard, Falcon, to live in our midst practicing gods know what. And now there's talk of rebellion and dragons? What help could Ygritte be against them? No. We can only rely on ourselves. You do well to remember that. All right, then.
Greybeards have summoned the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. Such a thing has not happened for hundreds of years.
You are new, huh? If you stand before me to accuse me of sacrificing children or eating the hearts of the dead, you may save your breath. I have done no such thing, nor do I intend to. I simply wish to live my life in peace. The people of Morthal would much rather weave their own horrid tales about my life than simply ask me for the truth. If they choose to fear me in their ignorance, that's their choice, but it will not change what is true. Till next time.
Inside.
Yeah.